Hey Pisces, welcome to your love reading for June 1st to the 11th for Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and Jupiter. So Pisces, really interesting. I actually wasn't getting a whole lot for you in my meditative session. I did get the sense of like keeping shit calm, keeping shit cool, keeping shit collected. I feel like you're feeling actually really balanced right now. They were showing me the moon. Like a full moon, almost like dark, like night had just like fallen over the land. Okay, that's kind of like what they showed it to how they showed it to me is really interesting. Like literally the sky just turned to night, like instantaneously, like a blanket of night sky just came over the land. And then they showed me a giant full moon. Oh, are you kidding me? Sorry guys. My automatic feeder for my cat hadn't been working, so I just was like, oh fuck it, I'll just put food in there for him. And now it's working, so he got some extra food. Anyway, I'm sure he's gonna be happy. So, Pisces, let's talk about you. Yeah, I just feel like you're really in your element, you're really in your intuition, and you're just like you got your shit together, man. You just got your shit together. Hold on, let me get some water. Pisces. Wow, that was weird. It's like my throat instantly dried out. I'm sorry, give me another second. That was really strange. Anyway, Pisces, yeah, it's just your intuition's on point. You're feeling decently well. I'm gonna say decently well because I feel like some of you are like a little shaky as far as your emotions are concerned. But for the most part, it's like you're just ready for the next thing. Ready for the next thing. Ready to keep it moving. Ready to keep it moving along. All right. I do feel that there's a lot of sadness around you, but it's not yours. Okay. It's not yours. It's for people who are connected to you or attached to you. Pisces, I kind of also get the sense that some of you might be trying to do your own thing, like trying to break out on your own or start something new for yourself, something that's very much about you and yourself and yourself. And it's kind of upsetting people. It's making people sad, which is interesting. It's better than them being angry, but it's interesting that it's making them sad. It's kind of bumming people out or people who are very energetically attached to you, okay? So let's look at the pre-shuffle cards. We have Seven of Pentacles, Taurian energy. Definitely feel strongly this is you. Pisces, really strong energy for you to harness because it's Taurus. It's very, even though it's Earth, which is usually complementary to water, I feel like Taurian energy and Piscean energy just should not ever go together, to be honest with you. Like, I don't think a Pisces should ever date a Taurus, only because Taurians are so, so rough around the edges in a good way. Taurians watching in a good way, but Pisces, you can be very soft, and I just feel like a Taurus would just be a little too cutting for you. You know what I mean? But anyway, bringing it back. I love that you're harnessing Taurian energy though, because it means that you're serious. It means that you're not bullshitting about whatever it is that you're working on. I feel a lot of projects kind of coming in for you, Pisces. Yeah, you're enjoying it. You're enjoying it. You know that you're going towards some really good things. You're just figuring out how to get there. Some of you have already taken those steps and you're enjoying the path ahead. Now, the bullshit that's going on around you, and I think bullshit that you're also trying to leave behind. We have Knight of Swords in reverse, Gemini energy, could also be fire or air. I'm just getting pure drama, honestly, pure drama off that card. And then we have Five of Cups, Scorpionic energy, with Queen of Wands, Aries energy, could also be fire or water. With the World in reverse, fixed energy, so Aquarius, Leo, Taurus, Scorpio. Also, this is Saturn, which rules Capricorn. Okay, yeah, major loss here. Major, major loss. And then we have a Four of Pentacles in reverse. Oh, big payout is what I just heard. Big payout, but like not in a good way. Not in a good way. Capricorn energy. Because Four of Pentacles upright is about saving money. Someone is losing money or paying out. Paying out, paying out. I don't know what that's about, paying out. Someone could be buying someone out of like a business or something of that nature. Someone could be buying someone out, or paying someone off. It's like it's got that vibe to it. It's got that vibe to it. And I feel like it's attached to the Queen of Wands. I feel strongly it's attached to the Queen of Wands, leaving someone very, very, very sad, leaving someone very much at a loss here. But there's a permanent ending associated with it. And like again, Pisces, I just feel like this is like around you. I don't even feel like it's about you. You're too busy looking forward, looking ahead. Well, there's all this drama and chaos and upsetness going on around you. Or again, people that you're energetically connected with. Okay. Yeah, this Queen of Wands, whoever that is, I feel like she or he, because it could be a guy, definitely left some oh shit. Sorry, give me a second. Oh, wow, Pisces. She or he definitely left someone in the lurch, okay? It's kind of what it feels like. Left someone down and out. Oh, you're sad that this is happening? Well, I'm going this way. You know, very much that kind of energy. Like, really did not give a fuck. Really did not give a fuck. I don't know who this person is, who this Queen of Wands is, but again, it's like, it's your energetic field. It's your energetic environment. You are too busy, Pisces, looking straight ahead, okay? All right, Pisces, so let's get into this for you. Hold on, pull my sleeves up. Get all ready and serious. For anybody who is not used to viewing tarot readings as a viewer, or who have questions about viewing readings, or like what readings you should watch, there's a little video below. Go ahead and check out the link, okay? All right. Oof, sorry. Any messages for Pisces regarding love? June 1st to the 11th. Any messages for Pisces regarding love? June 1st to the 11th. Any messages for Pisces regarding love? June 1st to the 11th. Any messages for Pisces regarding love? One more. Oh, well, June 1st to the 11th. What are those called? They're not merry-go-rounds. They're the big wheel. What are those called? Oh my God, it's gonna make me insane. You know, the wheel thing. It's like you get in the little cab, the little containment. I don't know what to call it. And it's like, it just takes you up and around, like on a little ride. Oh shit, I don't remember the name of that. I'm seeing that for some reason. I'm feeling a lot of different meanings associated with that all of a sudden. I actually get the sense of like being taken for a ride, going around and around and around, and when am I getting off? But also a sense of like nostalgia. Also a sense of nostalgia. Someone's being nostalgic for sure. Others are feeling like they're being taken for a ride. All right, let's see what else we get for you guys. Any messages for Pisces regarding love? Any messages for Pisces? Oh, jeez. Okay. Okay, I like it, Pisces. You could be an Aquarian, Piscean, Cusper. This is Aquarius energy. The star. Healing. Pisces, yeah, this is you looking ahead, man. It's like you got a lot of healing energy around you, but I feel like you're doing pretty good. So I feel like you've done a lot of healing already. A lot of you are also trying to just chase your dream, chase your wish fulfillment. It feels really good. But that's what you're looking towards. That's what you're trying to figure out while everyone around you is drama, sad or bummed out that you're doing your own thing or you're breaking out into your own. Some of you are coming out into your own, and that feels really good, okay? That Queen of Wands is coming back to me. I don't know your association with that person. We'll see if she comes up again. But that Queen of Wands is leaving someone very much in the lurch, Pisces, okay? And again, this is all in your energy field. Any messages for Pisces? Three of Cups, Cancerian energy. Yeah, I feel a lot of fun on this, Pisces. I feel a lot of fun. You're ready for fun. You're so ready, man. It's like, as much as you're ready to like work hard and get whatever it is that you're trying to break out into or strive for or get for yourself, you want to have fun. It's time. You deserve it, Pisces. You've had a rough time. You have. Any messages for Pisces? Any messages for Pisces? Page of Pentacles. I feel a date coming. I feel an invitation to go out for some drinky drinks or drinky poos. Definitely feel that. Pisces, you might get a little invitation. It might even just be friends, because this is also a social circle. It might be like, hey, let's go have a girls' night. Hey, let's go have a guy night. You know, very much like that. But I do feel it is an invitation for a date. Let's see what else we got going on here. And you are a Pisces, so they know to take you to a bar. Oh, my. Ten of Swords, Gemini energy. There's the end. End of the chapter is what I just heard. End of the chapter. Oh, chapter but not the book. Okay, interesting. Let's see what else we got going out here. You know, your friends could be inviting you out to be like, hey, forget about that person. Forget about that shit you were going through. Let's go have some fun. You know, it could definitely be that here. Or, you know, getting asked out on a date after you've gone through a breakup. Very indicative of that. Any other messages for Pisces? God, cards just want to fly out for you guys. The deck really wants to talk. Any messages for Pisces regarding love, June 1st to the 11th? Any messages for Pisces regarding love, June 1st to the 11th? Yeah, I'm getting some past energy here on these next two cards. We have Nine of Pentacles in reverse, Virgo energy, also my pre-Empress card, with Temperance. Temperance is making an appearance for everybody lately. Everybody needs healing, apparently. Sagittarian, well, I guess it's true. We all are healing all the time. Sagittarian energy. I feel like this is past energy for you, Pisces. I feel like this is where you're coming from already. This is what you're already leaving behind. Nine of Pentacles in reverse, I am getting like, what's this shaky energy with you? Shaky, shaky, shaky. Some of you might have a problem with anxiety, but instability on this card here. Temperance came in to help you heal and to help you find your balance, help you find your grounding again, help you find your footing again after some major ending they had to walk away from or heal from. And now it's like you're getting an invitation for a date, you're getting invited by your friends to go out and have fun while you are staying focused in trying to chase your dream, your wish fulfillment, and even more healing for some of you. Okay, overall energy, Pisces, we have the Hangman, Pisces. Underneath that, we got a King of Pentacles. Oh my gosh, Taurian energy could also be earth or air. Look what's underneath that, the Moon. The Moon, the Moon, the Moon. I'm keeping these three cards out as your overall energy. There's something you don't know, Pisces, and it involves the King of Pentacles. There's something very much hidden about this person. I'm actually seeing a little bit of like an energetic shield around them, okay? They could be, who had that? Someone had that. They could be a Gemini. Gemini had that going on big time. They don't have to be. I'm just saying, I wouldn't be surprised. But yeah, there's something very much hidden about this King of Pentacles, and it's something that, oh, come on. Come on, gosh. Pisces, and you've been very aware that there's something up with this King of Pentacles. You know this King of Pentacles. You definitely know this King of Pentacles and who they are to you, okay? For whoever this reading's resonating with, you know who this is, and I can feel it on your end, okay? Your intuition's been telling you something has been going on with this person, but you couldn't figure out what it was through your own intuition. So you have been in a little bit of a spiritual pause on it, like meditating on it, like marinating on it, like that sort of thing. excuse me. This person might come out of the woodwork very soon here. It might even be the person who's inviting you out to have fun, okay? But let's get into it and see. God, I'm being so drawn into this person. I'm sorry. Let's look at this person a little more. I don't know why they want me to keep focusing on them. As intuitive as you are, this person is intuitive as well. Maybe not to your caliber, but they are. They are. I just heard sneak attack. Sneak attack. They might be shielding themselves intentionally so that you don't pick up on anything about what's going on with them. Okay? Okay. All right. All right, Pisces. So let's get into this. So again, we have the Star and then the Page of Pentacles with the Three of Cups. I'm so curious about this energy. This energy is very big in your reading, okay? Let's look at the Page of Pentacles. Let's use Gilded. Let's use the Gilded deck. So I have the Page of Pentacles for Pisces regarding love, June 1st to the 11th. Tell me about the Page of Pentacles for Pisces regarding love, June 1st to the 11th. Tell me about Page of Pentacles for Pisces regarding love. Let's see what we got here. Ace of Pentacles in reverse. Delayed opportunity, missed opportunity. This person, whoever's inviting you out, feels like it's been a long time coming. And if it's your friend, it's been a long time since you guys had some fun, okay? It's been a long time coming for you to have fun, Pisces, if it's just a friend of yours. For some, I definitely feel like it's just a friend. Others, I definitely feel like it's a romantic interest who feels like they missed out on something with you or delayed something with you. Tell me more about the Page of Pentacles. Ooh, look, more Taurian energy. Hierophant. Ooh, I like it. I like it. I like it. I like it. Wow, this feels very clear-cut. Missed opportunity to commit. I just heard loyalty. Missed opportunity of loyalty. Well, that's interesting. Missed opportunity of loyalty. For some of you, this Page of Pentacles is most definitely this King of Pentacles, okay? Five of Cups in reverse, Scorpionic energy here. Hope. Hope is coming in. Faith is coming in. Faith is being restored here. Faith is being restored here, Pisces, on the part of the Page of Pentacles. They are having their faith restored in whatever they're trying to do with you, okay? Tell me more about the Page of Pentacles for Pisces. Eight of Swords, Gemini energy, trapped. This is how this person's been feeling. Very stuck. I'm actually seeing chains and shackles. Wow. This person's been tied up in something. It feels very oppressive. Very oppressive, very controlling, very dark. Okay, whatever it is that they've been trapped in, I have the sense that they're not completely out of it though. Okay, whatever that is. And if it's another relationship, please be mindful of that. All right. Tell me about the Page of Pentacles. Wow. Chariot in reverse, Cancerian energy with the Six of Cups in reverse, Scorpionic energy. Could also be past life energy, soulmate energy, karmic energy here, okay? This is a history of non-commitment. This is a history of a lack of growth here on the part of this person. And it's associated with that It's associated with that oppressive feeling. This person's been reminiscing a lot. You know this person. You guys go way back. They've been reminiscing a lot on painful stuff, on a lot of painful stuff and some good stuff. But whatever situation they're in right now, it's prohibited them from moving forward out of that past, out of the bad shit from the past, and honestly just moving forward in general. I honestly feel like this person's like been chained up. Like, you know, if they were in jail, that could definitely be. But I feel like whatever situation they've been in, it's really kept them stagnant, very much so. They've been very oppressed lately. Tell me about the Page of Pentacles. Tell me about the Page of Pentacles for Pisces regarding love, June 1st to the 11th. Tell me about the Page of Pentacles for Pisces. Okay, that really wants to come out. Let's see what we got here. Oh, wow. Knight of Cups in reverse, Piscean energy, hi. Could also be water or fire with judgment. Fire energy, also Scorpionic energy. Pisces, you might say no. I'm just saying. You might say no. Knight of Cups in reverse, it can be like an inappropriate lover card where it's like you're not giving anything to anybody or you're giving it all away. It could also be someone who's walking away from a romantic situation here. And I feel like that's what I'm feeling here. Walking away from a romantic situation. If this person wasn't exactly faithful to you, I was getting that sense of loyalty. That could definitely be the case here. With judgment though, with judgment being here, this invite they're extending to you, whatever this invite is, it's definitely something that's a step in the right direction. It's a step in the right direction. Overall energy for the Page of Pentacles, we have the High Priestess, Pisces. Could also be Gemini for me as a reader. A lot of intuition, a lot of intuition. Both of your intuitions are ridiculous, okay? Both of yours are. But they have you on their mind a lot. They have you on their mind very heavily. I just heard I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Wow. Okay. Well, I like that. I really like that. They feel like they missed out on something with you. They want to commit to you. They want that sense of loyalty kind of restored. They are having a lot more hope and faith in their life with this approach to you because they've been very oppressed in whatever situation they've been in. Okay. And I do feel very strongly that it is this King of Pentacles. Okay. All right. So like I said, a lot of this is past energy. Right? Like the ending you've left behind, the pain you've dealt with, the feeling unstable, not secure on your feet. Some of you might even struggled financially. You've healed from that. You've healed from that. Temperance is here. The Fix-It Angel is here saying that the spirit really helped you get out of those feelings. Okay. And now you have this invite invitation to go out and have fun from friends. For most of you, it is this King of Pentacles inviting you out and you have a history with them. I don't think it's a good one. All right. They definitely have a lot of shit in their past that they cannot stop thinking about and they can't stop thinking about you. Now I am really curious about the Star though, the very first card that we got out here. Usually I do it in order, but I felt really drawn into that Page of Pentacles, so I had to roll with it. But let's look at the Star in detail and then we'll use Oracle cards, okay? I was about to grab the Kipper deck and I was like, no, let's do an actual tarot deck. Alice in Wonderland to clarify the Star. Clarify the Star for Pisces regarding love. June 1st to the 11th. Tell me about the Star for Pisces regarding love. June 1st to the 11th. I think you're going to have a lot of fun with this person. I also think you're going to get whatever closure you may or may not, well, closure that you may not be aware you need, okay? Flame up the star for Pisces regarding love. Flame up the star for Pisces regarding love. Ooh, 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 hold on, what's this?
Ho, 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 yeah, Ace of Cups.
All right, first clarifier for the star. Ace of Cups can also be a lot about self-love and loving yourself enough to go for your wish fulfillment, but it is also a feeling of romance here, of a new start of a relationship. Let's see what else we got here. This could definitely be a renewal start for you in this King of Pentacles, okay? Not all of you are going to accept it, though, and I'm feeling that pretty strong. Tell me about the star. Seven of Wands in reverse, Leo energy. Being transparent and being vulnerable. Being transparent and being vulnerable. That's what you want. You want a very honest connection. You want an honest start. You want an honest start, an honest relationship with an honest person where everything is transparent and there's no secrets. There's no secrets. There's no defensiveness. Tell me about the star for Pisces regarding love. June 1st to the 11th. Tell me about the star for Pisces regarding love. June 1st to the 11th. Hold on a second. Hold on a second. Okay, there we go. There we go. Let's see what these cards are. Five of Cups in reverse, Scorpionic energy. Three of Cups in reverse, Cancerian energy. Wow, and then the Hermit in reverse, Virgo energy. Yeah, this is more of that healing that's coming in Pisces. Like I said, most of you have done a lot of healing. Healing never ends, and some of you have more healing to do from this situation. Five of Cups in reverse, yeah, it's almost like you're mirroring each other because, like, they're gaining hope, but so are you. So are you. But this is more about just getting over that pain, getting over the disappointment, right? After doing some major kind of inner work, being a little isolated, being in a hermit mode, you're done with that. You're very much done with that, okay? And you're done with the disappointment and you're ready to have more light in your life. Yeah, you're just really focused on moving forward towards what's really going to make you happy. Even if it is a relationship, you're trying to figure out what you need to do for yourself to get that dream relationship. Tell me about the star, whether it's with the King of Pentacles or without, okay? Tell me about the star for Pisces regarding love, June 1st to the 11th. Tell me about the star for Pisces regarding love, June 1st to the... Oh, okay. Got two more cards. Wow, I love it. Oh my God. Nine of Pentacles in reverse, Virgo energy with the World in reverse. Fixed energy, Leo, Taurus, Scorpio, Aquarius. It's also Saturn, which rules Capricorn. The instability in your life, Pisces, or instability or lack of confidence, financial problems you've been experiencing, over. It's over. That chapter is done. I just realized I was given that earlier. That chapter is done. That chapter where the fixed angel had to come in and help you get on your feet, help you heal, all of that is done. Overall energy for the star, we do have King of Swords in reverse. Very interesting. Aquarian energy could also be Gemini or Libra. Again, you could be a cusper. A lot of Aquarian energy right here. I don't like this energy. I gotta be honest, Pisces, be careful with this energy. This is energy you're harnessing. All right, sorry, a little bit of tough love. Didn't mean to get there so quickly, but just being honest. With this King of Swords in reverse, just be careful that you are not overcompensating for your big heart. Okay, so what do I mean by that? Pisces, you've been through some emotional shit in the last year. Hell, for some of you, last couple years, it's been extra emotional for some of you, okay? And I almost feel like this energy being harnessed, it's like overcompensating for that by like only being in the headspace, but in a way that is, God, I'm like, what's the right way to say this? Let me put it this way. The King of Swords in reverse, it's usually my narcissist card. It's usually my ego card, my selfish card, my taking card, okay? This headspace, is it efficient to getting what you want? Yes, absolutely. Absolutely it is. However, Pisces, it is a selfish energy, okay? And it's okay to be selfish sometimes, and I feel like you're in that mode of, it's time for me to be selfish, and I get it. Just don't take it too far. Just be careful with that is what I mean. Be careful with how far you want to take that. Yeah, just be careful. Just be careful. Just be careful. That's all I'm going to say. I'm going to say. Okay, Pisces. All right. So let's pull some advice for you guys. I really love your spread. I do. Because not only are you, you know, getting approached by someone who hurts you and someone who really wants to kind of make it right, even if it just means making amends and saying sorry or actually starting a new relationship. For some of you, it will go there. But you're so focused on what is going to be best for you moving forward. And that is your priority. And that is beautiful. And your instability, lack of confidence, financial problems are now over. That's awesome. All right, Pisces. Let's get some advice for you guys. Any advice for my Pisceans regarding this spread? 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 Come on. Any advice? Any advice? Any advice? Stay strong is what I just heard, actually. Stay strong. I feel like I got that for someone else recently. Stay strong. Might have been Cancer. Might have been Cancer. Wow. Oh, moth spirit, surrender now. 39, that breaks down to a 3 here, okay? 3 is usually about working with people and collaborating. Surrender, Pisces. I want to say it's about surrendering to the invitation. Surrendering to the invitation, hearing out what they have to say. Some of you might be too upset to, but I really feel strongly they want you to hear this person out, okay? Instrumental in where you're going is what I'm getting. It's going to be instrumental into where you're going, okay? You might pick up like a final lesson from this person that's going to help you to get that relationship that's going to work for you. Okay. Let's see what else we got here. Surrendering now is also about forgiveness and forgiving this person, releasing this person. It's also about that. Definitely also about that for some of you. Any other advice for Pisces regarding this spread? Any other advice for Pisces regarding this spread? Any other advice for Pisces regarding this spread? Okay. Now we have Scarab Beetle Spirit Magic Works Through You 25. Yeah, 52. 52. It's funny when it's backwards for me. I don't know if it's not backwards for you guys. But anyway, with the number 7. So getting on the right path. Very Seven of Pentacles energy, like just like the card you had in your pre-shuffle, and manifesting what you want for yourself and going for what you want. And that's exactly what you're doing. Time to manifest, Pisces. I don't feel like you guys have been doing a lot of manifesting. Manifest that dream relationship that you want for yourself, that healthy relationship that you want for yourself. Okay. All right, Pisces. I hope you guys enjoyed that. Don't forget to check out Patreon, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and all that stuff. I will see you guys later. Have a great night, Pisces. Namaste.